other side of a street I knew. Stood a girl that looked like you. I guess that's deja vu, but I thought this can't be true, cause you moved to West LA or New York or Santa Fe or wherever to get away from me. Oh, but that one night was more than just right. I didn't leave you, cause I was all through. Oh, I was overwhelmed and frankly scared as hell, because I really fell for you.
Echo down the hall. No one's there at all. Dial your number, but your voice is everything is inside out. I don't know what it's about. It keeps getting stranger by the day. Yeah. Stranger by the day. Yeah. It keeps getting stranger.
My heart is sinking. From you, and I can't believe I'm leaving. Oh, I don't know what I'm gonna do.
Thank you. The light and let it shine just on the night like the 4th of July. 'Cause baby, you're a firework. Come on, show 'em what you work. Make 'em go as you shoot across the sky.
En 10 regiones que ya se ha implementado.
Bueno, en cuanto a las demandas y a las demandas.
You were in high school, were you a troubled kid? Were you in trouble?
I mean, from maybe 10 years until 16, I was sort of like perpetually grounded. Because I started the first time I ever got in trouble, I was a good student, like straight A's. In fifth grade, I got caught passing notes talking about this boy named Troy Pruitt, who was my first French kiss.
Wow.
And he had hair like Zac Efron, I remember exactly. And I got caught, my mom got called into the principal's office, and I got in trouble, I got grounded, and then I escaped the house, I snuck out. And then I got grounded again, like for longer. And this just happened over and over again until I woke up and I was 17 years old and I hadn't left the house in 7 years.
And first time you appeared on the big screen, did it start to happen then?
Absolutely not. I was in a Viking. I was playing a Viking in a film called The Ring of the Nibelungs, which I don't think a lot of people have seen.
Ring of the Nibelungs?
The Ring of the Nibelungs, yeah. And I had a terrible wig on, and my entire part was dubbed over by another actor.
I remember seeing Harvey when I was very, very, very young. It had quite a stupendous effect on me, really, because I kind of thought, just Jimmy Stewart being brilliant, and also the idea that you can have a best friend who's a 7-foot rabbit was quite cool. I was a bit of a book hound when I was young. I used to shut myself away. I was a day boarder at my school, so I'd go finish school and I'd come home. I would generally eat 5 packs of crisps, 7 currant buns and 2 pints of milk, and then I'd go upstairs and just like, I've got no one to play with now, my brother's gone away. So I'd sort of, if you'll excuse the expression, entertain myself. And let's face it, I probably was doing a lot of that as well. Anyway.
I was horrified. I still remember the actual images that were disturbing as well. There are a few performances that have always been huge inspirations for me as an actor. After I was already in it and doing work. I saw Woman Under the Influence. I think I was about 16. I worked with David Fincher when I was really young doing Panic Room. When I see your face.
Altro che chiacchiere, il più grande spettacolo dopo.